So Duke has had a goal. No, he wasn't speaking as Dortmund, he was speaking as man. So sometimes he's speaking as God, sometimes speaking as man.
So he was 0% God, 100% man. That's what he said.
Can you hold this for 1 minute?
So basically during his ministry, he wasn't God.
Yes,
He was a human being and God at the same time. Exactly. You see what he said now? Earlier when we asked him, was he 0% God? He said yes. And now he's saying he's also 100% God. So if he's 100% God, how can he have a God? Think about it. It's incoherent. From any angle.
You'll never understand it.
You will not understand the matter if you come from the Allah perspective. If you understood it, you will be able to explain it.
It's a nonsense.
You can't have a square, sir.
It's a nonsense because you're perishing.
You see, this is what ad hominem says. The only way you can answer that is because what he's doing now is now blaming you for your misunderstanding of his incoherent concept.
So was Jesus immortal?
He's a Christian, by the way. He's not a.
Was Jesus immortal?
Yeah. No. On the cross.
What did he say?
He said he resurrected. Who resurrects? A mortal or immortal?
No. You're talking about...
Daniel, are you going to answer the question?
Timothy, you're going to Timothy after he resurrected.
No, but regardless.
Before he resurrected.
But who resurrects? Yeah, only the person who dies resurrects. If God does not die, then he doesn't resurrect.
He died in his humanity.
That means he's immortal. He's immortal.
So subject to death. Jesus was subject to death.
Exactly.
Of course. Okay.
That means he's not God.
But he says there's only one.
He conquered death. Don't end it.
You see, conquered death only comes if you die.
Yes.
If you don't die, there's no need to conquer death.
He said he didn't die.
That means he's immortal.
He was. And not only anymore.
Is God mortal?
Because
as in human nature. Do you understand this?
Is God mortal at any time? Forget about human nature. Is God mortal at any time?
No, your question is wrong.
No, your question is right. You're unable to answer it, so you make it wrong. How is the question wrong when God himself in the Bible says in 1 Timothy 6:16 that he alone is immortal? I'm agreeing with the Bible.
No, you're not.
You're the one who's disagreeing with it. So you tell me, post-resurrection or pre-resurrection, the fact that Jesus resurrected shows us that he's immortal. Because resurrection and crucifixion only applies to mortals, not to immortals.
Okay. Don't quote me post-resurrection,
okay?
Brother.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Post-resurrection, Paul also said the head of Christ is God.
He wants to say something. Go on.
Paul said, post-resurrection, the head of Christ is Almighty God. Are you saying that God has a boss?
All I was going to say is it's necessary that Jesus was perfect man, perfect God, and he died so that human sin could be forgiven. And the resurrection was the proof that it could be forgiven for the person.
By the way,
why did he have to be God?
Hold on.
That's God's way of doing it.
I'm sorry. It's not about God's way of doing it. It's about you guys changing God's nature in order to fit your doctrine in it.
Nope.
Your dogma has to fit. Your dogma has to fit in the Bible in order for it to be perfect.
The reason
the Bible actually states is that God is immortal.
Same question every week.
Immortal, and the same question you actually are failing to answer every week.
You haven't. According to your knowledge.
So you're saying God has a boss? Does God have a boss? Does God have a boss? The reason you are reluctant to answer shows the point.
Your theory, the Trinity, that's supposed to
be. Do you believe? No, honestly, do you believe God is the Almighty God?
God is above.
Does he have a boss?
I don't understand your language.
My language is English.
I know.
Which part of that are you saying you don't understand the English I'm speaking? So what are you saying? The word boss. That's an English word as well.
It says they're co-equal.
So do you not understand?
They're co-equal in divinity, but in his humanity,
The Father is above him.
Oh, so the Son has a boss. When he says above him, that means Son has a boss.
The Queen above you.
The Queen is not something in relation to what I am. I'm not the son of the Queen.
Answer the question.
I'm not the son of the
You're
Queen.
You're answering the question.
I am.
Is the Queen above you?
In what sense? Authority? In authority?
Is she above you?
In authority. In what sense?
I'm asking you.
No, but you need to clarify what you're asking.
What is the question?
The question. That is your question.
I don't think you understand.
He's asking me to clarify his question.
No, I don't think you understand my question.
Okay, so explain. The question, is the Queen above me?
Is she above you?
Yes, that's why I'm trying to clarify the question now.
Is she a human being?
Yes, she is.
Are you a human being?
Yes.
Simple. You're one being, persons. It doesn't mean they are above and he's better. It's about the person. The Father is above Jesus in personhood, not in being.
Where? So, you know, so when you say in person, how can you be above in personhood? No. Hey, Daniel, listen. You said the Queen.
Muslim never gets that. Hey, that's the worst.
It doesn't make sense.
Vegetarian doesn't get it. Doesn't make sense.
Daniel.
Show us in the Old Testament.
No, wait. Okay.
God is more than one.
Listen. He asked me the question about the Queen. The Queen is a human. I'm a human. But you said she's above me. Above me in what?
In authority.
Exactly my point. Yeah. You see, Jesus has authority over him.
We don't have a problem.
Can God have authority higher than him?
The Father.
The God.
And the Son.
My question wasn't the Father.
In
God.
His human nature.
God. Does God have authority higher than him?
No.
Thank you. Does Jesus...
In his human nature?
Things, yes.
Don't worry. So Jeremiah 32 says...
Daniel, listen to this. He said...
God is the God of all flesh. And Jesus has flesh.
Okay.
The Father is the God...
So you're saying during his humanity...
What does that mean?
No, what he's saying is that in humanity, when Jesus had authority. When he was in flesh, he had a higher authority. Is that right, Daniel? Okay. Post-resurrection, let's see. When Paul says, after Jesus has resurrected, in 1 Corinthians 11:3, the head of Jesus Christ is God. What do you understand by that?
It's the same thing.
Same thing? So basically,
he still has his human nature, brother. Oh, and his God nature.
So forever now, he's lowered in authority to the Father.
His human nature, yes.
He's always in human nature now, right?
He's also Alpha and the Omega.
No, but he's
so
always...
He has the divine nature too.
No, but he's always going to be lower than the Father. Daniel, hello? Why not answer it?
I never get that.
Why not answer it?
I've answered it too.
No, you haven't.
But you never get it.
You said...
That's why you come every week to ask the same question.
No. It's the same question, the one you don't answer.
He's asking you the same question.
When Jesus... He's saying Jesus is forever... You know what he just said? Jesus is forever now having the human nature. So forever, he's going to be subordinate to the Father. Is that right?
Yeah,
is that right, Daniel? Right. Oh, you're saying not right, so he's not. He's disagreeing with you.
Your
friend is disagreeing with you.
Your Trinity doctrine.
Okay, okay. Let me explain to you. Wait. You're saying that is not right. No, one at a time. You're saying that is not right because according to him, Jesus is always going to have the human nature from after his crucifixion. The question now remains: is he always going to be subordinate to the Father? You said you disagree with that.
What is First Timothy?
Daniel, have some respect for this gentleman. Let him speak.
Have some respect.
Yes.
You're the one picking up on
something. No, I'm asking him a question. Have respect.
I'm picking up on something you were saying.
No. Answer this question.
I was picking up on something you were saying a minute ago.
Which was?
Jesus actually will have his body for eternity.
Physical body. Did I disagree with that? I'm actually agreeing with you. Look, I'm actually agreeing with you.
You seem to suggest something else.
No. I'm saying Jesus, according to him and according to you, will always have this human nature with him after the incarnation. I'm not saying no. But the question remains, that also means that Jesus will forever be subordinate, subservient to the Father. Do you agree?
In his human nature, as I said to you.
Well, he's always going
exactly
to have
my point.
Nature.
You see, which shows that he's not the ultimate authority.
But your Trinity.
Thank you very much, Daniel, for agreeing.
How can they be co-equal?
They are not co-equal. Exactly. Exactly. They are not co-equal. They are not co-equal.
He's got the divine and the human.
They are not co-equal. According to him, he will always have the human nature with him. That means he will always be subordinate to God the Father.
Holding this tension.
In 1 Corinthians 11, he says the head of Christ is God. In 1 Corinthians 15, he says he subjects himself. He subjects himself after he's given the kingdom to God. You see, the very kingdom you guys are all pining for, he gives it to whom? The Father. And then he subjects himself to the Father. So forever he's going to be subservient to the Almighty God. And who's the Almighty God? The Father.
We've answered that question to you. Can we ask a question? How about Islam?
You can ask me a question, but why did I ask you another question on Christianity?
No,
go on.
You've already asked one question.
Yeah, go on, that's fine.
I wanted to ask you about Islam.
No, I said you can. Provided I ask you another question after that on Christianity.
No, you don't need to. You've already asked me about Trinity.
Why are you already afraid?
Answer this question first.
Yeah, go on.
Was Muhammad a white man?
What? No, he wasn't a white man. He wasn't a brown man. He wasn't a black man.
Let me read your source then.
Okay.
And then you get back.
What? You guys?
I haven't finished it.
You said one question.
Sorry, let me read
I've answered it.
Let me read your source.
Okay, go on.
If your source goes against you.
Yes.
You should ask him whether he's white or black.
Wait.
Are you white or black?
Let me read your source.
No, I want to know. Are you white or black?
Let me read your source. Sahih Bukhari.
So much desperation. This Christian evangelist.
You see how scared
look at
he is?
The desperation.
Yeah, why is he pointing?
You don't know.
Oh, wait a minute. You're from Batin. That means he's dead.
I haven't even read your source.
Let's listen.
Let me read your source.
Okay, go on. Read the source. Go on.
Hashim.
While
do you really want to talk to people who have in their mentality this inherent
complex
racism?
Already he's scared.
You see, the question
why
is...
Why are you scared? Let me read your
you see, we ask them questions about God, and what they do? They ask about whether he's black or white.
He's not answering the question.
Did I not answer your question?
Oh, the camera is here.
Daniel, did I not answer?
No, you haven't.
So, when I said no, that wasn't an answer.
That's going against your source.
So, did I answer? But the question is, did I answer?
Can I read your source?
No, did I answer?
No, you haven't.
Then you're a liar. Then you're a liar.
Can I read your source?
Yes, you can.
All right.
Let's have it.
While we were sitting with the Prophet in the mosque, a man came riding on a camel. He made his camel
afterwards or now?
Tied his pantaloons and then said...